And I have also read that you have a book of dreams. So what are the dreams achieved?
You know, promise to myself that I'll first create a platform for myself before I direct another film. I will establish myself as an actor and then I'll, you know, direct a film. That is already done, now I'm directing a film. And also, I wanted to create a platform for other filmmakers where they can make films without any compromise.
In general, my form of love is physical touch. So I don't find, I don't have inhibitions, you know, it's like, oh, he's a man, I should not touch, he's a woman. I have no such thing. If I love someone, I will tell them, you know what, I love you.
Born on 6th of June, that is 6-6. Okay. If you count the year also, it comes to 3.
Okay.
Yeah. And if you add everything, again it comes to 6. So it's all multiples of 3. Yeah.
This RRR team is still keen about building that dream.
I believe every industry should thrive not only on commercial films, but also parallel cinema, because this also has a market.
What's your introduction to Malayalam cinema?
Premam.
Oh, okay.
Actually, Premam. Like, it is such a cliche. I watched Premam, then I watched Kumbhalangi. I remember the order. Then I watched Kumbhalangi Nights.
You are directing Shivanna, and script is yours, and directed by Rishabh Shetty. Is this any kind of that kind of
like that? There is one script called Thugs of Malgudi, which I had to direct to Sudeep sir, Kitcha Sudeep.
So no plans for Yash also.
Stay. Then probably I'll explore all the actors.
As I speak, I get goosebumps. So I think I enjoyed it like an artist and like an audience.
It's okay to cry at someone's love story. Sapta Sagaradaache Ello enna cinema promotion vannappo Rakshit Shetty paranja oru vaakkaanu idu oru variyaanu pakshe side A kanda aarkkum adine eluppathi karanju theerkkan pattilla ore vattam rewatch cheyumbolum manuvum priyum anubhavichu vedanayundu adu ingane vingi vingi kotti valikkum അതിൻ്റെ ഏറ്റവും പേടിപ്പെടുത്തുന്ന ഒരു ഘടകം ഇതിനേക്കാൾ വയലൻ്റ് ആയൊരു സൈഡ് ബി അതിനുണ്ട് എന്നുള്ളതാണ്. സോ സൈഡ് എ ബ്ലൂ ആണെങ്കിൽ സൈഡ് ബി റെഡാണ്. എന്തുകൊണ്ടാണ് സൈഡ് ബി റെഡായത്? രക്ഷിത് ഷെട്ടിയും ടോബി എന്ന സിനിമയിൽ അമേസിംഗ് ആയ പെർഫോമൻസ് ചെയ്തിട്ടുള്ള ചൈത്രയെ നമ്മോടൊപ്പം ജോയിൻ ചെയ്തു. നമസ്കാരം. സോ ദിസ് ലൈൻ ദാറ്റ് യു ക്യാൻ ക്രൈ എ സമ്മൺ ആൻഡ്സ് ലവ് സ്റ്റോറി, ക്യാൻ യു എക്സ്പ്ലെയിൻ ഇറ്റ് വിത്ത് ദി പെർസ്പെക്റ്റീവ് ഓഫ് ദി സൈഡ് എ ആൻഡ് സൈഡ് ബി?
നോ, ഇൻ ദ സെൻസ് പീപ്പിൾ ആർ സ്കെയർഡ് ടു ക്രൈ. That was the reaction what we got initially. So actually crying need not be, you don't have to be so scared of, yes, of crying, right? Because right now you are not crying at your story. You are crying at somebody else's story.
Right.
So I believe crying can be very relieving. Whatever is stored inside you can come out. In a very beautiful way, especially when you're crying for somebody else, it's even more beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
So my idea was, don't get scared and not come to theaters. Come to theaters because it's a good film. It's okay to cry.
Side A had a potential to make us cry and weep for buckets. So what is side B?
Side B is not going to be, I think, cry. It's going to be very. An emotional journey will also be there. That is the main crux of the film, like Side A. But there will be a lot of, you know, if you have connected to both Manu and Priya, then there's going to be a very beautiful, a small love drama, and then a revenge angle also is there, because there are a lot of questions which is unanswered in Side A. So that will be answered in Side B.
Thing I noticed in both A side and side B also, there's a small snippet kind of a thing attached to the side A.
Mm.
The physical comfort you guys have is so good, so natural that when Manu and Surabhi looks at something, I don't know what that is, there's some kind of, not say chemistry, it's not the word, it's like some kind of easiness with your bodies.
Mm.
So what did that workshop do to you as actors?
There was no workshops like that. In fact, we only had 2 days of getting to know each other, like as Chaitra and Rakshith.
Okay.
That's all we did. But Side A, these people did so many different activities to establish the fact that they are in love for quite some time. But for us, since we are meeting for the first time in Side B, as Surabhi and Manu, and we are also getting to know each other like Chaitra and Rakshith in a very basic level. So we started off only with that. I think the physical comfort, it just came. In general, my form of love is physical touch.
Hmm.
So I don't find, I don't have inhibitions, you know, it's like, oh, he's a man, I should not touch, he's a woman. I have no such thing. If I love someone, I will tell them, you know what, I love you. So that is how I am as a person. So it was not that difficult for me to express that ease when I was performing with Rakshit, because otherwise also he's a great person to be around. So that comfort, I think, it just came in performance also.
I think in an interview in Times of Talananda, you told that I have to do a role that is that's not in my comfort zone. I have to break that comfort zone. So how much was Sudabhi out of your comfort zone?
Side B only is out of my comfort zone. Everything about Surabhi is out of my comfort zone. The decision to, be a part of this film only was out of my comfort zone. So there's a lot of things that I had to tell myself, and I was like, this is the time. I mean, if not now, when will you types? So that way, performance-wise, I had a lot of, that inhibitions that I had while performing also. Because the character has so many layers and I didn't know how to bring all of them to life, because I didn't know if I had it in me to do all that. But yeah, like I always say, they're great actors, a great director, who all of them came together and also brought the best out of me. So that way, yeah, I think it was worth it.
So I have heard about your emotion towards this multiples of 3. Is that true that you still set your ACs on 21 and 24, that is a multiple of 3? You eat once with a bite of 6. Is that true?
I do.
Oh God.
What's that actually? What does this multiples of 3 do to you psychologically? Because I have an emotion of 8. Yeah.
I have it for 4 actually.
Yeah. I connect 8 with this infinity thing. Uh-huh. So what's your multiples of 3 thing?
No, actually I was born on 6th of June. That is 6-6. Mm. Okay. And if you count the year also, it comes to 3.
Huh. Okay.
Yeah. And if you add everything, again it comes to 6.
Nice.
Yeah. So it's all multiples of 3.
Yeah.
So do you have an emotion regarding the take 3 or scene 3 like that?
No.
That much or not?
I don't go so deep. But I do. Like for example, now I come and come to this hotel, and they give allot me a room. So I see what number has come. See, here also I've got 3.
Yeah.
Yeah. So if you add everything, it comes to 3. So it keeps repeating. So that's all. Other than that, I don't take it more seriously.
Right.
So when I sit in the car, when I have to put AC, at what number you have to put? they would have put
at 17. Increase
a little bit. Or they have kept it at 20, so I didn't increase one.
Yeah.
So yeah. Huh. And otherwise, I don't take it too seriously. It's just that if it is very harmless, then I do it.
And I have also read that you have a book of dreams. And you have written some around 2 pages of your dreams.
Yeah.
So
everything is already
achieved.
Other than few of them, probably even that will be achieved in another few years.
So what are the dreams achieved?
For example, like after Ulidavaru Kandanthe, I made a promise to myself that I'll first create a platform for myself before I direct another film.
Okay.
So I will establish myself as an actor and then I'll direct a film. That is already done. Now I'm directing a film. And also I wanted to create a platform for other filmmakers where they can make films without any compromise.
Mm-hmm.
That also we have done. I produced a film called Charlie, 777 Charlie, which is a debutant director, Karan Raj. So he made the film exactly the way he wanted to make, without any compromise. And Sapta Sagaradaache Ello also, 1 and 2. And also many other films which we are producing next from Paramvah Studios. It's all that as if that dream has come true. So there are many dreams like that.
So what are the dreams to be achieved?
To be achieved, I wanted to build a house of my own.
Okay.
So now that it's under construction, it's not completed yet.
Loading.
Yeah, loading. And so there are many few more which probably I'll do.
Tell it after,
once it's achieved.
Achieved, yeah.
Nice.
I hope, I don't know, in side B you will be crying, because in side A he cried a lot. So So how this crying comes so natural? I mean, at some point you have to repeat the shot and the crying may get mechanical.
Correct.
But as viewers, we are seeing you for the first time. You're seeing Surabhi crying for the first time.
Right.
So what's the process? How can you cry so naturally? I've seen you cry beautifully in Toby.
That also came with the script, like how it's written. Even if, like, if I start thinking about that particular scene, I can still cry exactly like that because same kind of emotions is evoked inside. So with here also, I wish we could tell what happens inside us verbally, you know. I don't know how, it just happens. It's not like I am bringing some memory of, initially I thought we should get in our personal memories to act. But later I thought that is very personal. I don't want to get my personal stuff and work stuff, you know, and merge it. I don't want to do it. So then what you can do is get into the, like the details of the story. So then automatically, at least with respect to me, I can speak for myself. So when I'm reading Surabhi's role, there's a certain way it is written. And he's also our director, Hemant, will give us backstory to that also. So when I'm reading it like a third person, I am empathizing with that character already. Okay. So I'm rooting for her. So when I'm thinking, let's say, it shouldn't have happened. When I think already, I'm already feeling sad for her. So then I utilize that. So I consider myself to be Surabhi that time. So now I'm Surabhi, I'm walking, somebody is slapping me and I'll cry. So if somebody is slapping me, I get angry like a Surabhi. Only thing that I need to concentrate is not go out of, you know, character and slap him back like Chaitra. Just, you know, what Surabhi does is like, okay, now if somebody is slapping me, she reacts, walks and talks or cries in a certain way. That I should be very mindful of, not get lost is what I constantly think. But otherwise, it just happens. The script and the moment and the co-actor, everything comes together and you start feeling that you are that person. But it is never method acting because after the cut is done, I am back to being the normal Chaitra jumping around. So that is what happens inside me. I don't know how it happens to you.
Taking up a role is like a spiritual process. You take inspirations from the character for your personality. So how is taking up a role a spiritual process? Could you explain?
In a sense, I ask many questions to myself.
Okay.
What probably that character asks, character should ask himself.
Okay.
That question I ask myself.
Internally,
yeah. And in the sense, see, I never realized that it is a spiritual process until probably 777 Charlie. Only during 777 Charlie, during the second half of shoot, I went into a process where I wanted to learn about myself. I wanted to know myself because, you know, we are so busy with our life that at one point there are chances that we might lose that connection with ourselves, you know, completely. So I was in a phase where I wanted to know more about myself, and that's when I, you know, since I was only acting, otherwise I, you know, if I'm on the set, I'm doing everything. But here I was only acting, and since I had nothing else to do when, you know, they are shooting something else, so I used to just sit in the caravan, close my eyes and go into that meditative state and ask and start seeing things, what, you know, what's there inside, what are the kind of thoughts which comes, you know, if you just close your eyes. And when that starts coming and you start going, okay, why did this thought come, where is it coming from, and you go deeper and deeper and deeper, you start knowing more about yourself. Right. So I, during this process, when I was doing playing Dharma's character, I started asking, okay, now Dharma is a character who never loved dogs. It's not that I don't love dogs. It's just that I had lost that connection with the dogs. As a kid, I had many dogs at home, and once they passed away, I slowly started, you know, probably blocking that part of the internal me where I love dogs. And since I came to Bangalore, I had no dogs. But I used to see others, how, like for example, Hemant, he has two dogs, and the way he is with the dogs, or Raj, the way he is with the dogs. Why I can't be that? And I realized, oh, there are a lot of blockages which I have from my childhood. You know, why I stopped, you know,
connecting to
getting
dogs.
Along with the dogs the way I used to get along as a kid. So I got many answers there. Similarly, when I started playing Manu's character also, side A and side B, both Manu. So there are a lot of things which is there are similarities between me and Manu. Manu trusts everyone without you know, thinking.
Yes.
And then he you know, he's falls
so
into
desperate.
Trouble. He falls into trouble because of him trusting people without even thinking. So even I am like that, and even I have fallen into trouble just because, you know, I trusted people
blindly
many times. So where does that come from? So these are the things probably you know, helped me to play the character also. What I was doing other than during my free time, that helped to play the character, and help playing the character also helped this. And now when I look back of all the characters which I have played, and you know, at what point of my life I played those characters, I believe there is some connection, and that connection itself is very spiritual. Although I didn't plan it that way, but now when I'm realizing that how your work and life, you know, how they connect to each other, and how you know, spiritually it is about evolving as a human. So it has always been like that, right from my childhood. So yeah, that way it is spiritual.
So speaking about your stardom, there's something different in your stardom, and I find that is your smile. You have the most genuine smile of a superstar, and once a man becomes a superstar, he smiles with a swag, a different kind of a swag. But you smile so genuinely with your teeth, all seen. So there's an instant connect when I every time I see you performing on screens. So the thing is, once you get into this trauma of Manu, one scene after another scene, everything in the world bad happens to him, one scene after another scene. So promise me in side B, he will laugh.
I cannot promise you.
Will anything good happen?
Good
to
happen
him?
To me.
Definitely.
Yeah. Good things will start happening to me.
After watching the side A, many film lovers and film cinephiles in Kerala wrote Sapta Sagara has a resemblance to Kerala's own classic Yatra, which is a Mammootty star, which has the same kind of travel of Manu. He gets into jail, his love gets into trauma and all. So while performing a character, do you connect to any kind of film character, like in say in Geetanjali or
I never do that because first of all I want to play this character as me.
Okay,
it has to be very unique. I don't think so, you know. You have to find any of this outside. Everything is inside you, so inside only you have to find, because ultimately you have to play it. And I cannot imitate
someone else.
I'm 0%. So the best thing I can do is, you know the character, feel the character, and perform as much as I can, as Rakshit, how much I can be even. And there is always a director who, you know, looking into it. You know, as long as he's satisfied, as long as there is a smile on his face, I'm happy.
Watching side A, the thing was that after completing the film, the thing that hurts me so much is that the time when Manu and Priya was together was so beautiful. So that flashback is hurting me. I believe that you both will be in some kind of relationships in your life. So what hurts the most, the goodbyes or the flashback that followed?
I think the memories. Goodbyes, you choose to do it. After that, you will have to stay with the memories, no? So then, sometimes you'll be like, good that it happened. There'll be times where you'll be like, good that it happened. There'll be times like, maybe not. So I think the memories haunt.
Climax sequence, it's a metaphor that the site A may get into this physical violence zone, because Manu already gets into that physical violence. And there is an emotional violence also. The character may get into a zone which is not used to. So was that last sequence, which is actually a commercially overtop sequence compared to the other scenes, so was it a sign that sign B will be commercially big?
No, it is C. Manu See, there are two kind of people. One is, you make them angry, they'll show their anger right away. Mm-hmm. They'll react to it. If he has to hit someone, he'll hit someone there only. But there are other kind of people who will build it. Mm. That, you know, when you make him angry, he won't get angry. But something is building inside. You make him angry 10 times, he'll still hold it. 11th time, probably he's not able to hold it. He's, you know, that it erupts as a volcano.
Outburst.
So outburst, complete outburst. So inside here also, there are times when, you know, you feel like Manu should go and hit him.
Yes.
What is he doing?
Yeah.
Right? So there is a time.
Yeah.
There is a time when he actually picks up a stone.
Yes.
And but also why he's stopping himself is one mistake he does, that slight chance of going out of the jail and spending his life with Priya, that he's going to lose.
Right.
Which he's not going to he doesn't want to lose for whatever it is. Mm. It's okay, I'll take all the problems. I'll take everything on top of me, but I ultimately want to get out of this place, spend my life with Priya. Mm-hmm. That is the only intention. But at one point when he realizes that there is nothing, she's getting married, there is no story there.
So
I don't have, even if I go out, I have no one. So what's the point? So that's when he completely bursts out as a volcano. So it is not a commercial, we didn't put a fight sequence there because let's have a one commercial fight sequence. If that was the case, we would have done that quite a few times, which was possible.
Yes.
You know, but that character was built in a certain way, where one last outburst. Mm. So I believe side B also is going to be like that, okay. One big outburst. But this time he's not the same one.
Okay.
So probably here and there he won't
react.
He might react better.
Okay.
Or not exactly the same way. Now with the experience what he has
changed
with the trauma what he has gone through in last 10 years, and now he has nobody to lose. Then he had somebody to lose. Now he doesn't have anybody to lose. So you never know.
The viewing experience of Sapta Sagara Sai Day should be special to you.
Yeah.
Because you know what comes next.
Correct.
with the audience.
Right.
So what was it like? I mean, you have seen Sai Day, but side B is my territory. Was it that kind of a feeling?
No, nothing. See, what I understood after watching Sai Day was, oh my God, like now Surabhi enters to this love story.
Okay.
So she is coming to their story. And then later, so many things happen to her story also. I mean, there's already existing life that she has. And now, even though she is entering to their equation, they're also entering to her equation. So there will be some turmoil and so many emotions evoked there. So for me as an audience, oh God, I loved Sai Day. I cried like a baby. I remember I watched it like four times in theater, and then Amazon Prime. Now I'm forwarding and seeing my favorite scenes only most of the time. So it's become like I'm rooting as much as, you know, I am the Surabhi. I played it. I'm rooting for those characters. I also want them to be, you know, they come together. Some sort of solace that probably this character Surabhi also finds in the story. So all that, I am doing it like I am not a part of this film. So I'm treating it like one audience, and then I'm also telling, hey, please marry her. Hey, please do that to her. So I'm also doing that. So it was very difficult. It was very emotional to see them perform so well. Like, I had no idea. I had only read the script. But I didn't know these guys had, you know, Rukmini and Rakshit had put so much into those characters, that soul, you can see their souls, you know, like as Manu and Priya. That was very emotionally touching for me. And as an actor, it's very aspirational. I really want to do some work like that, is what, you know, as I speak, I get goosebumps. So I think I enjoyed it like an artist and like an audience.
So Prithviraj Productions is releasing the film in Kerala. So you told in the press meet that you had conversations with Prithviraj related to your movies, and the thing is that once he gets surety of a film and the stuff the film has, then only he will be part of the film. So what's the conversation between Rakshit and Prithviraj? How will it be like?
No, to be frank, this film, you know, so our sound engineer Rajakrishnan sir, he knows Prithviraj really, really well. So he's the one who actually recommended even 777 Charlie to Prithviraj. Okay. And now this film also, he only, you know, the first word went through him. So as soon as he tells him, I think there is one confirmation that this must be a good film. Mm-hmm. Because the sound designer, obviously, sound designer, he watches the whole film, right? So side A, the initial plan was to release side A only here.
Yes.
Because of Amazon, release, that didn't happen. But otherwise, Prithviraj's whole team watched the film.
Oh, great.
Side A. And they loved it. And they wanted to release the film. But because of these reasons, it didn't get released. So when I, you know, told them that, you know, side A has good response in Amazon, at least side B will release here. So initially there was like side A release, it didn't happen. Do you think there is enough, pickup, which is, I mean, enough people have in Kerala have watched it in OTT, are you sure about it? So I was like, yeah, you know, because we are getting a lot of tweets every day. I'm sure, you know, even if we release side B, people will come to theaters. So then after that, he said, okay, fine, if you believe, but you know, we are not releasing it like Triple Seven Charlie as, you know, in a big number. Let's have a smaller release, because this film is for a very niche audience, but the niche audience in Malayalam is big. So, yeah. So let's see how it grows. But as I said, you know, we are going to have a very, you know, decent number of theatres.
The RRR gang, That gang has some kind of aesthetics added to it, that you guys will come up with a very content-oriented film every time, even though it has a commercial angle associated with it. It may have fights, but the fights will have reasons.
Yeah, yeah.
So is this RRR team getting to an added responsibility or pressure at any point of time?
No, I don't think so. In the sense, now...
I mean, I have heard of your plan that by 10 years you will be building, I mean, you will be creating good movies in Kannada, and then you will be rebuilding Kannada to an audience which is very fairly forwarded when it comes to good cinema. Hmm. So, this RRR team is still keen about building that dream?
Definitely. It's not just RRR, there is Hemant Rao, there is Pawan Kumar, Lucia Pawan Kumar. There is Anup Bhandari, Kiran Raj, there is Satya, and there are many more filmmakers who are adding up. So, this, I believe every industry should thrive not only on commercial films, but also parallel cinema, because this also has a market. Mm. There is an audience for this kind of films too, and you can't ignore them. So, obviously, I see a very bright future that way.
What's your introduction to Malayalam cinema?
Premam.
Oh, great.
Actually, Premam. Like, it's such a cliche. I watched Premam, then I watched Kumbhalangi. I remember the order. Then I watched Kumbhalangi Nights. After that, I watched Trance.
Oh, great.
You know, when I watched first Malayalam film, Lockdown.
Oh,
yeah,
oh.
That is when I watched, and then I watched so many back to back, like one voracious Malayalam film watcher. Tara, I ended up watching so many random films. Like, I fell in love with the script, stories, performances. Oh God, yeah. And I learned so much Malayalam in lockdown.
Okay,
I can understand.
Watching movies.
Yeah, watching movies. I can understand Malayalam well because of watching movies.
Other than this language barrier that you can't speak Malayalam as eloquent as Malayalis speak. There is any kind of other, say, market values or industry differences that you can be part of a pure Malayalam film?
As I said, now that I've created the platform, now I want to direct more films than acting.
Great.
I will act in those films, but my concentration is more on direction. And so I have like 5 to 6 scripts which I want to finish first as a director, and then probably I'll. Or in between, if like after directing three films, I want to take a small break and, you know, act in one film and then go back to direction. If that happens, probably, if I get a good script, why not? But otherwise, right now I want to finish all this script which has been haunting me for a long time.
Prithviraj actually pushed the commercial angle of Malayalam cinema by directing Mohanlal sir. That was Lucifer. It may sound foolish, but is that you have some kind of dream that you are directing Shivanna and script is yours and directed by Rishabh Shetty? Is this any kind of that kind of plans? It is full on commercial, but still experimental.
As of now, there is nothing like that. There is one script called Thugs of Malgudi, which I had to direct to Sudeep sir.
Kicha Sudeep.
So that might happen probably after three, four films. That might happen. But other than that, I don't have any other.
So no plans for Yash also.
No, not immediately for sure. Probably once I'm done with acting, I'm completely only directing from now on. If I reach that state, then probably I'll explore all the actors.
Side B will be a new world, I believe. And I hope the world will end with happiness.
Yeah. You'll come out of theatre with complete satisfaction. That, yeah, this story is satisfying.
Film is releasing on November 17th. What should we expect?
A lot of drama. There's a lot of drama, and then we will make you feel all whatever we are feeling. You will feel all of that emotionally. So please come watch it in theaters on November 17th. Is all I can say.